The 2023 Lexus RZ450e is the company's all new and all electric SUV. It looks like a Lexus, it's built like a Lexus, but there is one problem. It's got a range that's shorter than a celebrity marriage, about 2/3 that of a Tesla Model Y. But there is a silver lining. Buckle up and let's go for a drive. I'm your host, Brian Max, racer, lover of driving fast, fun things. And on this channel, you get reviews for drivers from drivers. Now, Lexus has been a bit slow with their EV launches. This is the only one in the range, and it is related to another vehicle we've driven recently, as we will discuss. But before we get into what this is like to drive, let's have a look at this RZ450e in a little more depth. One thing that's interesting about this RZ450e is that it's made in the same factory as some of the same cars we know and love, like the Lexus LC500 and GR Corolla. On top of that, as you may know, it is related to the Toyota BZ4X and Subaru Solterra, but it's actually more powerful than both of them. There's a 150 kilowatt motor at the front and 80 kilowatt motor at the rear, and think about that for just a second, but it does have a total combined power output of 313 horsepower and 308 pounds of torque. The battery is a 71.4 kilowatt hour battery with max DC fast charging of 150 kilowatts, not bad. Maximum range is 220 miles or 354 kilometers if you have the 18-inch wheels and tires, not these 20s. So this one's range is said to be 196 miles or 315 kilometers. This one is equipped with the standard electric power steering, not the fancy yoke that they've teased at Lexus. Suspension's based around McPherson struts at the front, multi-link at the rear, two piston brake calipers at the front, single at the rear. There are four levels of regen, wheels and tires, 18s or 20s, and 20s are only available on the upper trims. Inside, there's the big new infotainment screen that Lexus is putting in their latest models, loads of safety tech. This also has a digital key with up to 7 different profiles, which is a good thing. You can have your wife, your family, even your mistress on those profiles. On the other hand, if you get caught by your wife with your mistress, you might get divorced and sued, and that is definitely a bad thing. Curb weight of this RZ450e in its top trim level is a little over 4,600 pounds, which is not as bad as I would have thought. Did you know that about 80% of you are not subscribed? Yes, it's true. I checked the data and 80% of you are not subscribed. So if you enjoy the content on this channel, do me a solid, hit that subscribe button while you're at it. Be sure to like this video and share it. And if you don't mind, drop by our merch store. There's lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Now back to your regularly scheduled episode. The seating position is almost perfection, and it's for a few reasons. One is that hip point is perfect. There's no stepping up into this, and there's no dropping yourself into it either. So it's very easy to get in and out of this thing. Once you're here in the seating position, visibility is excellent in all directions. Yes, there's lots of cameras and sensors and all of that stuff, some of which we will discuss later, but visibility is top-notch here as well. After that, we've got a perfectly supportive and comfortable seat. Lots of adjustment in the seat, as well as the steering column. Great shape on this steering wheel. Encourages you to have your hands at 9 and 3. I've got a great relationship to the pedals as well. I really can't complain about this at all. And at first level ergonomics are concerned, loving the layout. Very clearly laid out digital instrument cluster. It is on the smaller side. It looks like it's big, but it's actually contained in this small center section. There's a heads-up display on this. One of the ergonomic shortcomings from my perspective, but I am getting used to this, is the layout for some of the controls. We've got some generic switches here on the steering wheel. Those are repeated in the heads-up display. So you've got, you know, track or channel adjustment on the left, and then you've got your adaptive cruise or cruise controls buttons here on the right. And there's no indication on the switch what it controls, but then you have to look on the heads-up display and you see what it is. I'm kind of getting used to it now. It's been a little while. It's probably taken me 3 or 4 drives and different Lexus models to figure this out, and that's okay. Problem is, if I put on my polarized sunglasses, my visibility to the heads-up display is a bit reduced. After that, we've got a big screen in the modern style. It is not just infotainment. it is a bit more than that. Climate controls are built into this. What I do like about the system is that it's fairly straightforward, if a bit basic and not perfectly intuitive, but it is easy to navigate. What I really like about this, however, is how Apple CarPlay is rendered on this. It works flawlessly. You can do it wired or wireless. There is wireless charging. Lots of USB connections in the first and second row. The only other ergonomic consideration, and does take a little bit of getting used to, is this shifter, and it is the oddest thing. You sort of push it down and then turn it to the right for drive and then left for reverse. That's fine. You have to press the park button if you want to park the car. If you're stopped, you can just turn it off by hitting the power button. It'll automatically go into park. One thing I am impressed with is how well finished and how everything has a high quality touch inside this cabin. It is exceptionally well finished, high grade materials kind of everywhere. There is not a stitch of leather in sight, and I actually really like this upholstery. I like a high tech sort of ultra suede or Alcantara type upholstery. This works exceptionally well in here. It's right on point, and on top of that, it's got this funky sunroof situation. It's photochromatic, and with the touch of a button, it goes from mostly clear to completely opaque. It's a very, very, very cool touch. It is quite spacious, both here in this first row, in the second row, and under the hatch. Very impressed with that. There is a bit of storage down here. I don't know if you can see it. There's some storage underneath the armrest as well. A little bit of storage in the doors for smaller bottles. My water bottle that I am using today does not fit in these door pockets, but really can't complain about that. In terms of spaciousness, this can definitely fulfill the needs of a young, busy family. Okay, you know, Lexus says this will do 0 to 60 in about 5 seconds, and that's definitely a good thing. On the other hand, if you're doing that with passengers on board and they suffer from motion sickness, well, if they make a mess on the carpets, that's probably a bad thing. The acceleration characteristics are really defined by these motors. So they've used the front-wheel drive motor from the Toyota and Subaru versions of this on the front axle, and then the standard one at the rear. So there's a more powerful front motor than the one at the rear. So this tends to drive in some instances like more of a front wheel drive crossover than an all wheel drive one. And it would be much more interesting if they reversed them and put the small motor in front, big one at the back, give it more rear wheel drive dynamics. And the thing is, we no longer need those front wheel drive characteristics, at least from a packaging standpoint, when it comes to EVs. That's a completely different consideration. Why not put the powerful motor in the back and give this more interesting dynamics? What happens from time to time is you do get a little bit of a torque steer. You get a little bit of that front wheel drive kind of behavior. It's not that prevalent in day-to-day driving and regular driving. You're never going to notice it because this is a very refined EV. But every once in a while, if you mat the throttle, you mat that throttle pedal, when you're in a turn, it does give you a little bit of torque steer. It does give you a little bit of push. If you are more refined with your driving inputs, you're never going to see those characteristics rear their ugly heads. On the other hand, with electric motors, engineers have greater control over the electric motors in terms of their torque outputs than they would with a fully mechanical system. So this puts down power basically flawlessly anytime you need it. It's actually very, very quiet in here. And of course, with the low center of gravity, it's very well behaved. But in terms of putting down power, there's no trouble putting down all of this power and all of this torque. And it's really just a little over 300 horsepower at a little over 300 pounds of torque. It's not massively powerful. So for a city size than a city size EV crossover, it makes a lot of sense. In terms of dynamics, it is surprisingly good in a number of ways. And we'll get into this as we break down the dynamics of this RZ450e. Handling, well, that is predominantly determined by the fact that the majority of the weight is in the floor. I'm sure this is a 1,000-pound battery pack. It's a 70-plus kilowatt-hour battery pack, so there's a lot of battery in the floor. And in corners, there's really not a body roll. It is impressively flat when you're cornering. Corners incredibly flat, and that is a real surprise. We don't have a sophisticated suspension system here. We've got McPherson struts at the front, multi-link, no adaptive dampers, yet it corners very, very flat. That is impressive. Overall, suspension tuning seems to be a decent compromise between ride and handling. It's only when you get to the absolute limits of grip where this RZ450 kind of says, "Now I'm not really interested in playing at these limits, so you might want to slow it down." It just feels a little awkward at its limits, but this is not something you'd take to the extremes, that is for sure. Ride quality is exceptional, and body and wheel motion is exceptionally well controlled. These are just standard dampers, but that speaks to how well Lexus's engineers have tuned the suspension. It is absolutely fantastic in day-to-day driving, and the fact that it's an EV means it's very, very quiet in here, so it's an overall relaxing driving experience. One of the more impressive things about this Lexus's dynamics is the braking. I did read the press release and they said, well, they took careful consideration when it came to engineering brake feel, and I have to say they did that. And the reason they have to do that with EVs is because there is regenerative braking. This one has four levels of regen. And what that means is you can do, you know, kind of one pedal driving, but the transition from regenerative braking to the pads coming in contact with the rotors through your pedal inputs is very difficult to blend. And what Lexus has done is blend that perfectly. And on top of that, brake pedal feel, when you're actually braking through the brake pedal, it is exceptional as well. It feels very clear. Modulation is very clear. And you have tremendous confidence to be able to control this Lexus RZ on that brake pedal. I'm very impressed with the brakes. Yeah, I'm a brake pedal feel fetishist, but Lexus definitely scores top marks with this brake pedal. There are some drive modes. There's Eco, of course, there's a regular one, there's a sport mode. I find that the sport mode is a little bit more aggressive in terms of throttle mapping, and that is about it. After driving the BZ4X Toyota, I do have to say the driving experience is completely different, and of course, there are a lot more features and luxury touches in this Lexus versus the Toyota, as you'd expect, and overall, it's a very different driving experience. It's a much more luxurious and on Lexus brand driving experience in this RZ450 than the Toyota, that is for sure. How do you spec yours? Well, it's a fairly easy question to answer because there are just three trim levels. These are not product plan the same in Canada and the US, so you can't exactly get this in the US and vice versa. What you are looking at is a fully equipped RZ450e, less the yoke steering wheel and associated steering bits. In the United States, this is the luxury model. In Canada, it's the executive. Base price in the US is $58,500, and as tested, it's about $64,000. In Canada, base price is $64,950, and as tested, it's $80,950. Those prices are before freight, local taxes, and local rebates, of course. Now, in terms of speccing yours, it's a matter of two things: your color choice, and of course, which options and which features you want. I kind of like it fully equipped. I like everything about this equipment level. It works very well for me day to day. And in terms of speccing yours, just pick the color, pick the trim, and be happy with your RZ450e. My verdict? Well, let's talk about range for a second, and we're not getting exactly as advertised. Right now, during my test, during this week of testing where it has been cool, I'm actually seeing the car report that we're getting about 150 miles of range, about 240 kilometers or so of actual range, which is less than promised. That probably has to do with the fact that the battery pack has to keep itself warm, so we've got reduced range in cooler weather. As for that silver lining, here's the thing. This is a Lexus. It's built and it's engineered by Lexus, and they have the resources of a much larger company than Tesla. No, I'm not talking about market capitalization. I'm talking about depth of engineering. And this is a fantastically well-built EV. It does everything I wanted to do. No shortcuts, no shortcomings. Its range, however, definitely makes this more of a city crossover EV than anything else, but it is a very luxurious one at that. Thanks for hanging out with me today and having a look at this 2023 Lexus RZ450e. Hope you liked this episode, and if you did, you're not new to YouTube, you know what to do. Smash the subscribe button, turn on your notifications, like this video, and as always, sharing is caring, so please share this with your friends, especially on Reddit, because on Reddit, they really need to see reviews for drivers from drivers. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comments below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. And if you want to support the channel, please hit up our merch store. Links here, links below. Lots of great stuff for driving enthusiasts like us, including our very popular line of Save the Manuals merch. Thanks again for watching. We'll see you again next time. And remember, cars don't understeer by themselves, not even Lexus EV crossovers.